night. It is time.
Good evening, and welcome to Saskatchewan Television, CKCK-TV, Channel 2, Regina. You are now entering a new and ultra-modern world of entertainment. The sights and sounds of the world around you, right in your own living room. And we at CKCK are committed to bring you the very best in this new and growing medium called television. Stay with us now as we bring you tonight's broadcast.
CKCK television saw a lot of changes during the progression of the 50s, but the enthusiasm and the excitement of that initial broadcast still prevailed. Television was very new, and all local programs were produced live in the studio. The only exceptions were the occasional network shows that were pre-recorded on film and then sent by plane the following day. And during the time, Channel 2 usually started its broadcast day at 4 p.m., but viewers would have their television sets turned on hours before, listening to the music or watching the test pattern, not wanting to miss the first program, of course. Television was also considered a luxury, and in the evenings it was not uncommon to see a whole family with added friends and neighbors huddled close together watching their favorite show. Local music and variety shows were popular back then, and because they were broadcast live, using only one camera, almost anything could happen. Commercials were also done the same way, and many times the announcer either forgot his lines or was caught unprepared. From a technical standpoint, CKCK was quite advanced, and in the following segment, we'll see a station tour explaining how the modern miracle of television really worked. Locally produced shows are also highlighted. Let's watch.
Is Western Canada's first privately owned television station, CKCK-TV's facilities. Administration offices occupy the front part of the building and include the sales department, the production manager, production supervisors, and promotion manager, as well as the traffic department. Greeting the visitor in the front of the building is a comfortably furnished viewing room, where one can watch the current show in progress. An interesting display is the case containing a portion of the 1,300 tubes used in the transmission of a show. Modern decor is the keynote in furnishings used throughout the station, and the client's room is no exception with its attractive drapes and modernistic furniture. In the client's room, a rather unique setup allows the prospective customer to view a show as it would appear on his home set. Now, this is done through the use of mirrors in the projection room, which is also used for film auditions. Many a contract has been signed over a cup of coffee, and the staff room also provides an ideal place to discuss the latest program idea. These ideas are then carried to the production department, where five writer-producers turn out all local requirements. A great deal of their planning revolves around the storyboard, which is planned in conjunction with the art department. Here, the visual planning ability of the artists moves to the fore in outlining film animation and the plans for commercial work. This are kept to sport their equipment to various assignments, which include trips to outlying districts, in order to bring viewers complete coverage of up-to-the-minute news. This film unit works in conjunction with the editing department to produce local feature films. In the program division, a full-time librarian receives and dispatches films used throughout the operation. And she also card indexes all slides and opaques used in the day's operation. Before any actively in programs and in commercial work, they are also experienced in appearing before the live camera in the studio. One of the jobs of the studio director is to direct all live camera movement. He is, therefore, connected with the operator of the camera and directs all moves from the control room.
Okay, dolly back. For a full shot. And cut and reposition on the party line kitchen.
That have taken place. Included is a modernistic kitchen, which provides an ideal setting for CKCK-TV's popular afternoon show, The Party Line.
Well, Doreen, those didn't seem like very difficult recipes that you went through today. Do you think they were?
No, I don't think they were, but I think they're awfully good.
Well, I know they're awfully good. And let's pull that old magic trick of showing the folks the finished product even before they're baked.
All right, let's go over and have a look at them.
Now, this is the sample that you had all prepared for us before the show. Now, what did you call them again?
Well, these are our ginger snaps, and these are the sandies, and these are our deluxe brownies with chocolate mint frosting.
They're my favorites, that's for sure. Well, now, if the ladies didn't manage to get the recipes copied down while you were baking these delicious goodies, what do they do?
Well, they can just write into the party line, CKCK-TV Regina, and we'll send them out just as quickly as we can.
Well, now, say, what about tomorrow's show? Do you have a guest cook all lined up for us?
Well, we have a very special guest cook for tomorrow.
What kind of food do we have?
Italian.
Oh, boy. Any particular?
Oh, yes, pizza and lasagna.
Pizza and lasagna. Oh, what a feed we're going to have tomorrow with our guest cook that we feature each week. But that pretty well takes care of everything in the kitchen for today, Doreen.
Yes, it does, Jim.
Right now, I think we'll just wander off into the living room to have a chat with our special guests for today.
The regular feature every second Monday on the party line is sewing instruction. And this afternoon, we're happy to have with us once again Mrs. Jessie Heil of your Singer Sewing Center in Regina. What's for this afternoon, Jessie?
A carriage cover and pillow.
I see you're using your very quiet and very lovely Singer automatic this afternoon, Jessie.
Yes, I am, Shirley. This is the new automatic they have, though.
Mm-hmm. Now, you've already quilted your end piece, is that right? And that's what you're sewing on?
Yes, the top part, or should I say the quilted part that we have for the lap over on the underside of the carriage cover.
Just a reminder to our viewers, if they would like this pattern, all they have to do is drop in and see Mrs. Heil at the Singer Sewing Center or send us, here at the party line, a self-addressed stamped envelope, and we'll be glad to send you the pattern as soon as we can. Just about through, Jessie?
Just about near the end of it.
Well, there we are, all through. Now, let's have a look at the finished product. The carriage cover with its neatly quilted ends and the matching pillowcase. Thank you very much, Jessie, for being with us once again this afternoon. Remember to join us 2 weeks from today for more sewing instruction on the party line. Bye now.
Now here's the news. The mayor of Regina for the past 3 years, Mayor Leslie H. Hammond, announced his retirement from the post.
Two local newscasts interspersed the schedule.
Civic Voters Association as mayoralty candidate for the forthcoming municipal elections. He said he will not run against the association nominee, Alderman Joseph Wilkie, who has served on Regina City Council for the last 12 years.
CKCK-TV has a teletype service, uses international film news services, as well as extensive local film news.
Don McPherson, Joseph Young, Ross Sneath, L.M. Robinson, and hardware merchants Fred Mullen and Jack Peart. The Royal Canadian Air Force has unveiled its $40 million air base at Cold Lake, Alberta, for the first time since the base went into operation back in 1954. The base is located 145 miles northeast of Edmonton, Alberta. Bulldozers have fashioned the base out of the northern Alberta bush to house CF-100 fighter jets.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome again to our sports desk. While football is still high in the limelight as far as the Western Interprovincial Football Union is concerned, and tonight we have news about the releasing of one import and the bringing back into the fold of a very important halfback to the Edmonton Eskimos. Tonight, tackle Bob Dean of the Eskimos was released by the Grey Cup champions in order to bring back into the fold Johnny Bright. Dean, who was the club's place kicker for the past year, has been a valuable cog of the Eskimos' drive to the Grey Cup in the past 2 years. Bright, as you know, suffered that dislocated shoulder, but returning now to the limelight makes, again, the Edmonton Eskimos a big threat in the conference. Finally, this hockey news tonight, the Warwick brothers will play for Trail in the Western Interprovincial Hockey League this year. Dick Warwick said today that Grant has been signed for playing coach and that he'll Bill will come along with him as well to help out with the team. Now, that about takes care of our sports news tonight. We'll be back with you again tomorrow evening with more sports results. Until then, good night, everybody.
Channel 2's popular weatherman predicts the latest in weather.
Well, there's my interpretation of the Mexican sun dance in order to bring on a little more of the sunshine and keep it going.
There are various interchangeable sets for the local shows, which are included in the schedule running from 3:30 until midnight.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Supper Club. We had a kind of an interesting time last night, didn't we? Besides the interviews that were carried out, we had the old-time fiddlers. Four of them. They were excellent. Reminds me of last summer when we had the first Commonwealth Hereford Bull, the champion. He's the first one that ever existed, and we got quite a kick out of showing him. I know a lot of the old-timers around here got a kick out of it because we got quite a response from it. Well, tonight, we're going to have some interesting interviews just a little bit later on. And as is the case, we've got something interesting on tap again tonight on the Supper Club.
When my boom turns to gold again.
Another popular summer show is the Sunday afternoon feature, Twilight Reveries.
When my boom turns to gold again, you'll be back within my arms to stay.
Thanks, Wally, for that fine rendition of When My Blue Moon Turns to Gold Again on Twilight Reverie.
sir, next on the Ray Little Show, a real fine country song, Columbus Stockade Blues.
Way down, Columbus, Georgia, wanna be back in Tennessee. Way down, Columbus Stockade, friends have turned their backs on me. Go and meet me if you want to, never let me cross your mind. In your heart, you love another, leave me down and I don't mind. I dreamed I had you in my arms. When I woke, I was mistaken. I was peeking through the bars. Go and meet me if you want to. Never let me cross your mind. In your heart, to love another, leave me down out of
next on the Ray Little Show, a real fine country song, Columbus Stockade Blues. Let's go.
Way down, Columbus, Georgia, won't be back in Tennessee. Way down, Columbus Stockade, friends have turned their backs on me. Go and meet me if you want to.
A story of how the huge resources of a television station can be mobilized to serve people and of how people reward it in return. This station has all the familiar television paraphernalia. A studio with its maze of production gear, complicated looking control areas, a telecine room with its projectors for film and slides, videotape machines, and a transmitter to deliver her programming to viewers. She has capable, industrious, imaginative people with a wide variety of skills and talents. But good talent and good equipment won't captivate anybody without the addition of another ingredient. That ingredient is purpose. And that purpose is to identify with and work with individuals and organizations for a better, more prosperous, and more productive community. Live television, we call it. How does it live? Not by its own breath, but because it breathes life into things local people are thinking and saying and doing.
So we maintain a large and well-equipped news department to keep Plains people informed, Not just about events around the world, but around the corner as well. Plains people have learned to trust the information they receive on 2, 6, and 12. Guidelines are maturity and responsibility, and these are reflected in the personnel who gather and deliver the news.
Again, it is my privilege and honor to advise of another birthday for CKCK-TV. This marks the completion of 8 years of television to a wonderful audience that comprises the community in which we serve. I want to thank our viewers for their patience and their understanding and for their fine cooperation during these exciting and interesting growth years. We have grown from 17 employees to 85, from a building and equipment valued at $750,000 to a capital investment of approximately $2 million. Our plant is now one of the finest in Canada, equipped with the latest equipment in the field. We have been successful in our application for a satellite at Colgate, Saskatchewan, and I trust we will be successful in our applications for Willabunch and Tagaski. With the addition of these areas, CKCK-TV will serve in the neighborhood of approximately 90,000 homes, by far the largest audience in the province. To that truly wonderful group of people who comprise our staff, I want to express my heartfelt thanks for our truly great contribution to our community and to our great industry. A happy 8th anniversary.
Although many people were responsible for the initial organization and building of CKCK Television, two veteran broadcasters, Mr. Harold Crittenden and Mr. Lloyd Westmoreland, stand out as the driving force behind the evolution of television in Saskatchewan. Mr. Crittenden, formerly general manager of CKCK Radio and now vice president of Armadale Communications Limited, came to Channel 2 in 1954 and was appointed the station's first general manager. Mr. Westmoreland was CKCK Television's first sales manager and subsequently became assistant general manager in charge of programming. His contribution toward television programming was unsurmounted and is proven by the high ratings CKCK has maintained throughout the years. And it was also his initial involvement that led CKCK to become recognized as one of the more prominent television stations in Western Canada.
It's Daniel West and Matt and May. We hope you like the show we have for you today. See those ponies along. Hear the cowpokes singing a song. There's Batman, Judy, Buckaroo. We'll be coming back another day. And we'll hit the trail and yonder we'll go. To your Western Theater show. To your Western Theater show.
Presenting worldwide and local news to Channel 2 viewers in southern Saskatchewan on CKCK Television.
Well, hi, little buckaroos. Mighty glad that you could drop into the old ranch house this afternoon. Yes, sir. Now, you just tether up your ponies and sit a spell, because we got some mighty big doings going on this afternoon. Yes, sir. Now, everybody settle down and get ready for Western Theater. Howdy there, partners. Desperate Dawn's my name. I ride out here for the Circle 2 Ranch. Say, sure glad you dropped around this afternoon. Gets kind of lonesome out here on the ranch. And, say, why don't you come along with me? I'm all set for some righty fast action coming up right now, so what do you say we take time out to see today's Western Theater?
We'll be back in one moment.
I've been down here now 6 foot about a 10. I'm in now 10. I've been down here now 15. 15. I'm in now 17. 52. I'm in now 2 and 2500. I've been down here now. Oh, 3,000. Oh, that's point.
If we give jobs to workmen now who are idle, it could result in a greater saving for the community.
More employment and more paychecks spent in the community could result in greater prosperity for everyone. Well, now, wasn't that a humdinger of a story? Hope you liked it. Now, that's all for this afternoon, but you come back again next time we have Western Theater. So long for now, and be real good little buckaroos.
It's time for your CKCK television sports scope. 10 minutes of sporting highlights and headlines from the sporting world.
We've got the tops in westerns to the darling. Keep tuned to this channel all the while. Channel 2.
CKCK television, The Silver Years. We'll be back right after this.